conversation continues. We're going to talk about how to receive feedback now. Welcome back. My name is Derek Christopher Campos, and this is The Better Way. Last week's discussion about giving feedback was great. There was a comment that was made regarding how to receive feedback, which is equally important, and I thought I'd take just a few minutes to discuss that. Because just as it is a talent and a skill to give feedback, it's also a talent and skill that requires practice and attention in order to receive feedback. Let me give you a good example. So not too long ago, I was giving a nice presentation to a group of executives. It included a PowerPoint, which I thought was very well done. It was being recorded, I had a microphone on, they had the video cameras out, and everything was going great. Afterwards, the cameraman came up to me after shaking my hand and saying, "Hey, that was a great presentation, I really enjoyed it." He says, "Can I make a couple suggestions?" And I thought, well, sure, go ahead. He proceeded to give me a few suggestions about my PowerPoints and how I can make them a little bit better by making just a few little tweaks. As he was telling me this, my mind was thinking, how dare you? I had to fight off that thought and think, hey, Derek, he's trying to help you by giving you some pointers and tips. He's probably had a lot of experience and he's trying to share something of value with you. So I had to take my pride and set it aside so I could understand that he was trying to help me. And the pointers that he gave me were very beneficial, and I've actually incorporated them into my future presentations. For some reason, the more senior you get in your job, the more you think you know it all, and the less likely you are to accept advice from somebody who is simply trying to help you. So my advice is simple. When receiving feedback, stay humble. I know it's difficult for a lot of us, but set your pride aside and remember that feedback, when received correctly, can be very beneficial to you professionally and personally. Anyway, those are my thoughts and opinions. I want to hear from you. This week's The Better Way Challenge is this. Think of a time when you've received feedback that was a little difficult to accept, but upon accepting it, you realized that the feedback actually made you a better person. Well, hey, that's all the time we have. Be sure and follow us next week where we'll be talking about the Thumper Principle. It's going to be a good one. I appreciate you taking this journey with me. Be sure and like, follow, and subscribe to keep track of all things The Better Way. Once again, my name is Derek Christopher Campos, reminding you that there's always a better way. We'll see you next week. When I wake up in the morning.